Hello everybody, Teagan here with High Point. Thank you so much for tuning in to another episode of What is in the Night Sky this month, April 2023. Tonight I'm going to be taking you on a beautiful tour of the night sky in the month of April. We're going to visit some awesome objects, including star clusters, galaxies, nebula, and we're going to see what the moon and the planets are up to. So as always, buckle in and let's see what's really out there. The first object on our tour tonight is a deep sky object. We're going to travel 41 million light years away from our solar system to visit these two beautiful galaxies, Messier 65 and Messier 66. March and April bring on spring, which is also known to many amateur astronomers as galaxy season. Messier 65 and Messier 66 are a fine pair in the constellation of Leo. These galaxies were discovered simultaneously by the French astronomer Charles Messier on March 1st, 1780. If you live under dark skies, you'll be able to spot the pair with binoculars, but otherwise, most scopes will do the job. M66 is slightly larger and a bit brighter, with small scopes showing a sizable halo with a bright oval core. Larger scopes, 10 inches or larger, will reveal some texture with dark bands near the core and the possibility of seeing the spiral arms. Telescopically speaking, you should be able to observe these galaxies through a telescope at about 50 times. Pushing it any higher than that, then you're bound to only see one of these objects. The next object on our tour of the night sky in the month of April is Malat 11, otherwise known as the Coma Star Cluster. Visible from suburban locations, the Coma Star Cluster is located roughly midway between Denebola in Leo and Cor Caroli in Canes Venetici. This Y-shaped star cluster is large, relatively dense, and is best observed with a pair of binoculars. Now, if your location suffers from light pollution, you'll probably need binoculars to locate it, but binoculars are actually best for observing this cluster anyways. So far on our journey, we have visited a galaxy group, we visited a beautiful open star cluster, and now we're going to take a look at a planetary nebula, Messier 97, also known as the Owl Nebula. Again, first observed by Charles Messier in the March of 1781, Messier 97 lives just 2 degrees from Merak, one of the stars that formed the Big Dipper. It's visible in a small telescope at low power, but you'll most likely need a high magnification to see the eyes that give this nebula its name. Now, in Charles's notes back in the 1780s, he wrote "difficult to see" next to his observation. Now, he was using a rather small telescope, of course, but you may experience the same thing with a smaller telescope as well. You'll need something around a 10-inch or 12-inch aperture to really see this nebula in full. Now, before we move on to our last deep sky object, which is a gorgeous galaxy favorited by amateur astrophotographers, we're going to bring it home. We're going to see what the moon and the planets are up to. Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune are too close to the sun to be observable this month, but Mercury continues to climb into the evening twilight. Start searching low over the western horizon about 15 minutes after sunset. The planet will be highest at greatest elongation on the 11th. Look for a very thin moon below Mercury on the 20th, and then to the upper left the following night. Mercury will then be lost in the twilight just a few days after. Venus, on the other hand, is also visible in the west after sunset and passes the Pleiades star cluster on the 10th and 11th. A crescent moon joins Venus on the 22nd and 23rd. Mars spends April in Gemini and is joined by the nearly first quarter moon on April 25th. Saturn is now finally visible in the pre-dawn sky and can be seen low to the south-southeast shortly before sunrise. A waning crescent moon appears 5 degrees to the lower left of the planet on the 16th. The moon itself turns full shortly after midnight on the 6th, with the new moon just shortly after midnight on the 20th. Now we're going to stay within our solar system, and we're going to check out something that's going to be happening within the month of April as well, the Lyrid meteor shower. definitely something to check out. The Lyrid meteor shower reaches its maximum around 9 p.m. on the 22nd, with a crescent moon setting early in the evening. These meteors are bright and can produce fireballs. This year, the moon is just 3 days old and will set early in the evening, leaving observers with dark skies unhindered by midnight. Under ideal conditions, you can expect to see around 18 meteors an hour, with your best chance coming after midnight. The best equipment to view the meteor shower is not a pair of binoculars, nor is it a telescope, but dark skies and your naked eyes. The next and last deep sky object on our list is Messier 106, another gorgeous galaxy. Messier 106 was discovered in 1781 in the month of July by Pierre McCain. Visually speaking, both small and medium-sized scopes will show an elongated patch with a bright core, while larger scopes, 300 millimeters in aperture or more, will reveal a mottled surface. Look out for hints of its spiral arms with averted vision. Now, I say this is a favorite among amateur astronomers simply because its core is absolutely gorgeous to photograph. It is a great target for both beginner, intermediate, and advanced amateur astrophotographers alike. All right, well, that is our tour of the night sky in April. We thank you so much for tuning in. If you have any questions, please let us know in the comments and we'll be more than happy to assist. If you've ever seen or photographed any of these objects, let us know as well. We always love to hear from you. Thank you so much and clear skies.